Yeah, a little bit later.
Before I go into the global partnerships, I noticed there's a lot of people here that's all been 360. Mother mentioned Fusion 360. There were some people that had an idea of what Fusion was, or have used it, but not many have actually probably got a good idea of where things are going. Now, what I found in Europe and the way that I see the construction industry developing is it's the product manufacturing and construction starting to get closer and closer together. There's a lot of building construction going on where things are prefabricated outside, so it's like the modular design. Things are being done, you know, through product development offsite, and then it's turned up pre-constructed, and then they're, you know, modular built on site. You're talking about robots now doing 3D printing on concrete. So there's a lot of developments in that sort of area where Fusion 360 and BIM are starting to move a little bit closer. So I just wanted to show, just before I go on to the global partnerships, a quick video that was put out a while back on Fusion 360. I think we've got that.
We are entering a new era of manufacturing. An era of massive change and disruption. An era in which you've got to evolve to stay competitive. Where the key to success is innovation. Today, the future of making things is forcing product designers, developers, and manufacturers to rethink the way they design, make, and monitor products. Why? Because consumers expect smarter, connected, and more personalized products than ever before. Autodesk is embracing this new era of manufacturing and creating the solutions you need to stay competitive. Introducing Fusion, a cloud-connected product innovation platform. It's not just a CAD or CAM tool, not just a PLM or IoT tool. It's all of these and more. It's a true SaaS product development platform that allows you to rapidly create generatively designed products, metal 3D printed products, products connected to the world around you. Fusion brings together a set of apps that helps you design the products of the future that are optimized to perform as great as they look. That helps you make products using advanced manufacturing techniques to achieve higher quality and lower costs. That helps you understand how customers use products. Gathering real-world data and closing the loop to inform future innovations and shorten the development cycle. Fusion was designed to run entirely in the cloud. There's no hardware to buy and maintain. No costly upgrades, and your data is accessible anytime, anywhere. With Fusion, industrial machinery manufacturers can evolve product lines to incorporate IoT, creating new revenue opportunities and service capabilities. These new product lines include sensors and electronics that collect real-world data. Data that is based on usage performance that feeds new features, functionality, maintenance, and product optimization. With Fusion, you can detect patterns, make isolated or full-scale adjustments to save time and money for you and your customers. You can make more informed decisions based on real-world metrics collected from your products. With Fusion, you can achieve competitive separation by leveraging operating data from your products in the field, gaining insight to provide higher levels of service, customization, and design optimization. Get ready for the future of making things. Innovation starts today with Fusion by Autodesk.
Yourselves, the ATC partner over here, is a set of resources that you can use to inspire students. Now this is based on Fusion, but we're also going to be using LinkedIn as well, which is a spray document that gives resources for the partners to use, for the educators to use, and teachers, and they'll go through the different types of workshops, how to deliver their workshops, give links to resources, to videos that can be used, and to, you know, to schemes of work that can be implemented. So this is something that we want to do, working with yourself to develop the whole, our own Hong Kong regional, you know, set of standards and workshops that can be developed and put out there to inspire the next generation of students. So that's very quickly, and that's my little short piece on that. Can you throw this up there? So, if global partnerships, these are organisations and competitions, global competitions that Autodesk partner with to help inspire the next generation of designers, innovators, and it brings education and consumers, customers together to work together to really make the next generation of designers inspired and wanting to use Autodesk tools. So the FOE Schools program, the students work with industrial designers, with their educators, to actually design a concept mimic F1 formula car, which will then be CNC machined out, and using a CO2 canister, will be fired down the track. And it is a global competition, so we run local, regional, national and international events where the students will work with customers, will compete against each other, and eventually will take place adjacent to the F1 track as well. So like the world finals actually happens just before the Singapore Grand Prix. So the students meet like McLaren and, you know, all the top designers. And it also gives a pipeline to these organisations as well of talent. World skills, not many. What we'd like to do is build our partnership with World skills. These are the next generation, these are apprentices, students that are in college and university, or they're an apprentice working with an organisation, whether it be BAE Systems or whether it be a construction company. It could be a plasterer, it could be a. They do cake decorating, but there are a lot of CAD skills. And we want to invest our partners getting involved with these students to build up the skills and be the pinnacle of the competition. That's what we want to do. And then with Vectra Robotics, there's a design challenge with the Vectra Robotics competition. So it's really, these are the ways that we can invest, you know, time. Their partners getting involved, and we're here to actually support that. I'm glad that we actually go on about this. I think we'll move on next, because that's what you're talking about. If I get carried away and get into it, then but one of the things we are looking at is there is going to be a big design for industry competition that's going to be coming up. And I see that Hong Kong will be an ideal region to really invest in that competition. That will be sponsored by, I'm not sure if that's going to be sponsored by.
So work on details, and I'd say to that extent, what we tend to do is qualify partners who are, they play the role of judges. So, you know, this is the part of our stuff I've developed, and I can tell you that industry is really passionate about the next generation, and so we don't put anything at all on partners who participate as judges, with the exception of asking them to judge some of the student work. And also to give back. So as we're moving down the path of launching a BIM challenge for the Design for Industry program, if there are partners that you think would be really great global partners to participate in, you know, being an industry leader who's aligned to that competition and has interest in helping to judge and also connect with students to that one-on-one turn block, we'd love to collect any recommendations you have for or just generally that are here. BIM is a huge opportunity in Hong Kong, as you know, and it would actually be really great for us to find a potential partner and group of judges from this market. So, think about that.
Yeah. And we'll have a joint comment everyone in here that when the finals is done, I'll be correct, but we'll just be picking the winner from Hong Kong.
I think that's
the goal.
Yeah, I just wanted to say one thing. So if you've ever tried to work with the education space, it's a maze sometimes, right? The answer is almost always no. I don't have a budget. It's in a different budget. I'm not responsible for that. My dean says no. My principal says no. Whatever. It's always kind of navigating that maze is very difficult. So Steve was a professional engineer for 16 years? 18 years. Oh, I thought you said 80. So
don't feel like
speaking in a grade right here. And then he moved into the education space and he taught technology in the UK for
13 years,
which makes him 80 years old. but the great value of having a Steve Taylor on board is that when you have an idea, you can kind of work the details out to say, what would be a successful proposition to go into this education so that we hear yes instead of no? So where's the budget coming from? Where are the right people to contact? What do we need to put together to get in there? And then once we start having success in that space, you know, success, build on success, and then once we get the model in, then that's what we do. Steve's a great resource.
I've already actually started making some connections with local schools and universities and training organizations in Hong Kong to actually gauge, you know, teacher trainings that are required. The organization that can help us help you to train the next generation and get involved with their students. Because I see it that, you know, we need to be training students now on the next generation of tools, not the ones that are currently being played. There's a lot of AutoCAD being trained, not AutoCAD will always be there. But in 5 and 10 years
thank you.
understanding of the things that we're planning to do, or where we want to work together with you.